Good
Morning,
morning,
ma'am.
ma'am. Good morning, students. In the last class, we studied about sexual reproduction in humans. Today, we are going to discuss a very serious topic called reproductive health. Although signs of puberty appear in males and females much before their mind and situation are suitable to enter into the sexual act to produce children, therefore, boys should not produce children before the age of 21 and girls before the age of 18. Legislations in our country also instruct the same.
Ma'am, what are the harms if a boy and a girl enter into the sexual act to produce child before the age of 21 and 18 respectively?
Although signs of puberty and feelings to enter in the sexual act appear much before than 21 years in the boy and 18 years in the girl, it is particularly not good for a girl to carry a fetus before 18 years of age because her uterus wall is not fully developed and she is not in a general state of health to carry the developing fetus for 9 months. Therefore, to conceive before the age of 18 for girls not only violates the legislation but also causes a negative impact on the health of both the mother and the child. Now it is time to tell you about certain diseases which are transmitted through the sexual act, particularly in those who are not involved in safe sexual act and their aim is not to produce children.
Ma'am, how diseases are transferred through the sexual act?
There are certain bacteria, fungi and viruses which cause diseases like gonorrhea, syphilis and AIDS, which are transmitted through the sexual act. These microorganisms find a suitable environment around the male genital organs and female reproductive tract. They survive comfortably, result in STDs, which in severe situations cause death of the individual.
What is the full form of STD?
STD stands for sexually transmitted diseases.
Ma'am, won't this cause panic among boys and girls?
No, one should not panic about the occurrence of such diseases. They occur only in those people who are involved in unsafe sexual acts.
Ma'am, what is unsafe sex?
Unsafe sex is that when a person is involved in sexual relationships with more than one partner and without precautions.
Ma'am, what are the precautions to avoid unsafe sex?
Use of condom in males may prevent many STDs.
And ma'am, how can pregnancy be avoided?
The sexual act always has a potential to lead to pregnancy. Pregnancy will put major demands on the body and mind of the woman if she is not ready for it, and her health will be adversely affected. But there are several ways to avoid pregnancy. These methods are contraceptive methods which fall in a number of categories.
Ma'am, what are the contraceptive methods for the female?
One category is the creation of mechanical barrier so that the sperms do not reach the egg. Condoms serve this purpose. Another category of contraceptives acts by changing the hormonal balance of the body so that eggs are not released and fertilization cannot occur. These drugs are commonly taken orally as pills. Since they cause hormonal imbalance, they create side effects in the female body. Other methods of contraception such as copper T and loop are also used and they are placed in the uterus of the female. But they also cause side effects like irritation of the uterus.
Ma'am, if pregnancy is so demanding on the part of female, are there any other methods to prevent pregnancy?
If the vas deferens in the male is blocked, sperm transfer will not take place. If the fallopian tube in the female is blocked, the egg will not be transferred to the uterus. In both cases, fertilization will not take place. Surgical methods can be used to create such blocks. Although surgery is quite safe, in the long run, surgery may lead to infection and other problems if not performed properly. Surgery may also be used for the removal of unwanted pregnancies.
Ma'am, can we determine the sex of child before birth or during pregnancy?
Yes, by ultrasound or sonography we can do it, but it is not permissible by law.
But why is it punishable?
Because this may be misused by people who don't want a particular child, as happens in illegal sex selective abortion of female fetuses. This is called prenatal sex determination, which results in declining child sex ratios and is a matter of great concern.
Ma'am, what is child sex ratio?
Child sex ratio is the number of female children per 1000 male children in the age group of 0 to 6 years in a population.
But ma'am, is it necessary to produce individual as they may increase our population?
Very good question. It is true that nature has provided the facility of reproduction to all organisms. But if the ratio between birth and death is disturbed, the population continues to increase. The resources on earth are limited and cannot support exponentially expanding population. Reduced resources not only disturb the physical and biological scenario of the earth, but also reduce the quality of living and standard of life. I hope by now you have understood the concepts of reproductive health. See you later. Goodbye, students.
Thank you, ma'am.